Come on, wake up at 6:50 a.m. Please, let me sleep for 10 more minutes. No, no, our faculty member will not let us enter. Come
I'm
on.
Still sleepy.
Wake up, I said, just wake up.
Okay, fine. But I was awake whole night. I was preparing for presentation.
So do I, but wake up.
Okay, can you do me just a favor? Can you just give me a cup of coffee for instant charge up?
All right, I'll just bring it.
Thank you. Oof. It all starts with NESCAFE. Start.
Good afternoon, everyone. I, Neha Pathak.
And I, Sakshi Sethi.
From the river Krishna. Are here to give presentation, and our topic is Redvolution, Repositioning the Brand NESCAFE. A scoop. Scope, introduction, product range, competitors of NESCAFE, USP, unique selling point, market share, challenges faced by NESCAFE, Redvolution and repositioning of brand, promotional strategies, and the last conclusion. Over to you, Sakshi.
When it comes to introduction of NESCAFE, it was introduced in Switzerland on 1st April 1938. And the parent company is Nestle, and the current managing director and chairman of NESCAFE India Limited is Mr. Suresh Narayanan. With the brand ambassador Disha Patni, it has a tagline, it all starts with NESCAFE. Let's get to the background of NESCAFE. How did NESCAFE evolved? During 1930s, it was due to upon the request of Brazilian government, NESCAFE was requested to produce coffee cubes. So NESCAFE started looking out for the possibilities of creating soluble coffee. Later on, which will be as equally good as other present competitors at that time. So later, in later 1930s, with the help of Mr. Max Morgenthaler and its team, NESCAFE introduced soluble coffee to the world on 1st April 1938. And it is a coffee that has lived through World War, Cold War, and has even been sent to the moon. With backed by a pipeline of innovation and a thorough commitment towards its customer satisfaction, NESCAFE has given throughout commitment towards new consumers and even retaining their trust.
Product range. There are so many varieties and flavor in NESCAFE product, that is NESCAFE Classic, NESCAFE Green and NESCAFE Green Blend, NESCAFE Blend and Brewed 3-in-1, NESCAFE Ready to Drink, and one more unique product, that is NESNICO, in which nicotine gum is present to attract smokers who want to quit smoking. And I also want to add one point, that each country has a slightly different taste in coffee, NESCAFE coffee, because of its local variety of brand. Competitors of NESCAFE. NESCAFE is a big brand, so these are the two major competitors of NESCAFE, that is Tata Coffee, which is launched in 1922 and its headquarters is in Bengaluru. And it is the first coffee that was brought in South India. And the Brew was launched in 1968 and its headquarters is in Mumbai. And it is India's first coffee which is Chicory mixed instant coffee.
When coming on the unique selling point, what creates a differentiator for NESCAFE apart from its competitor? NESCAFE sells its products at the same prices with the market average, just like its competitors. But the difference is it sells its products with the high customer satisfaction level and with no compromise of quality. Another differentiating factor is its restructured red mug, which was welcomed as a symbol of love, hug, and happiness. While looking on the market share, market size, and its competitors, Nescafe in India has a maximum market share apart from its competitor. Another one is Unilever's Brew, and others may have Tata Coffee, etc. Nestle India Limited has a market size of 1,11,975 crore in the food processing sector, under which beverages that are powdered one have a contribution of 1,522 crores of sales value, that is 13.48% of its total sales. And revenue of financial year 2018-19 was 8,3,732.49 crores.
Challenges faced by the challenges faced by the Nescafe brand. The demand for instant coffee around the whole world gets slowed down because of the at the beginning of 20th century, because of the consumer preference. Consumers started preferring freshly brewed coffee over instant coffee, and eventually sales of Nescafe started declining since 2008 till 2013. And the other challenges they faced is health conscious people avoid coffee because of the caffeine present in it.
Redvolution, repositioning of the brand. What actually repositioning is? It's when a company changes a brand status in whole marketplace. And Redvolution was a repositioning campaign that was launched in that started in 2014 with to consolidate its competitive advantage over the marketplace, to enhance its iconic potential across all touch points, and redefining all the identity systems of the brand by adopting a master brand vision. Nescafe sold same characteristics across all 180 countries where it was sold. And Nestle introduced one single identity vision by communicating a same communication strategy for all Nescafe production. Repositioning strategy was actually centered around only three visual markers. First was the block mark called hub. Second was the restructured red mark. And third was the accent on the logo. Before coming on the promotional strategies, Nestle is such a powerful brand that its development is till such an extent that it has not only targeted the premium consumer, but it has even targeted the mass market end. That was a clear strategy of the brand. So whether it's by collaborating with influential celebrities or by using other collaborations through advertisements where consumer reactions can actually make or mar a brand. So first is collaborating with George Clooney in US ads. It's more than a decade that Nescafe has collaborated with Mr. George Clooney for their promotion campaigns. Second is Really French Project created a 42 video web documentary with over 8 million views. This was a remarkable video that started and initiated through Facebook, which actually led in eventual increase by 400% in their followers through Facebook pages. Third was Good Morning World campaign 360 degree video. It was actually the famous cup song introduced by Nescafe through their campaign. And last is the users for social first approach. Through the platforms like Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat, Periscope, etc., Nescafe has led through these platforms.
Conclusion. From launching India's first portable coffee machine, Nescafe E-Till building coffee culture. They have grown on the commitment to maximize the enjoyment and ease of preparing a cup of coffee within a few seconds. And it is an iconic, competitive and potential brand as it research about the consumer need, preference, and they also research about the slowdown and cope up with the new strategies. They also engage in social media platforms to advertise their new products, and they also come up with campaigns to bring people together campaign like O campaign in Mumbai with a tagline Badal Life Ki Raftar, which focus of the plan behind that.
Next. Thank you.